What's a real fact that some people don't want to accept? Most people think they are slightly more intelligent than the average person. They are not. Myself included. No one owns life. But anyone who can pick up a frying pan owns death. /Williams Burroughs. Participating in and deriving joy from other cultures and their activities is not the same thing as cultural appropriation. Obesity is not healthy and is generally from eating too much. Many people don't wash their hands in the bathroom, unless they see someone else in the bathroom. Nuclear is the safest source of energy and a viable solution to reduce our CO2 emissions. Being a rep for an MLM does not mean having your own business. Also, it's impossible to make even minimum wage as an MLM rep without exploiting at least someone. Click farms and bot influencing are real. The number next to the view count /likes/favorites/shares is a line of code. Not empirical fact. Trends are purchased. No one really thinks about you, so stop worrying about what other people think about you because they're most likely thinking about their own problems. Vaccines do not cause autism, you absolute pebbles. The average person is significantly less conscious and autonomous than we like to pretend. We are a unique species in that we have the mental potential to break free from our base animal instincts. That doesn't mean everybody, or even a majority, of people actually reach that potential. Trolls don't hate you. They just try to stir you up to get a reaction. If anything, they are just bored people who sit behind a screen. Budgeting is not difficult. It is basic math. Credit cards are not magic free money. They will eat you alive. She's not into you, bro. She's just being nice. That not everybody is nice, or even capable of becoming decent people. Some people are just bad. And functioning psychopaths are all around us. America is not immune to uprisings, dictatorships, and the collapse of democracy. If we allow it, it can happen here just as it has happened in other countries. The only real reason it has never happened before is because we are such a young country. Almost every society in history has had some form of slavery. We have all a bad side. A side we don't others to see. So we hide it away and put on a facade to cope with life. Everyone is entitled to their opinion. That does not mean all opinions carry the same weight. Less 30 minutes of Googling articles you already know you'll agree with does not count as research. Oh. You did research on climate change /vaccines/border security/any other subject? Let me read through your methodology. Was it qualitative or quantitative? Where was it published? Could I look at the data you gathered? What did the review board have to say about your processes? Were you sufficiently able to provide recommendations and disprove prevailing counterpoints? I researched this. Fuck outta here. We are all getting older. All of us. All the time. You can fight it and you can make your face look like smooth plastic and your body look like a 12-year-old boy's with big tits. But that number is still only going to go in one direction. The majority of people in this thread don't know the difference between a fact and an opinion. People will not change their consumption habits or lifestyle choices to become more sustainable until the impacts of climate change / pollution personally impacts them. Mental illnesses can be just as deadly as physical illnesses. Also, you can't tell a depressed person to be positive. That's the same as telling someone with high blood pressure to just lower your blood pressure. The earth is round. Can't believe we are actually having to debate this with people today. The world isn't and can never be completely fair. Learn how to deal with this internally, without blaming everyone else for your misfortunes. Nobody cares about an inside joke that doesn't include them. Even when you hastily explain the story behind the joke, if you weren't there, then it's not funny. You can state facts but without proper context. They merely highlight your ignorance at best. Your intent to mislead at worst. No one owes you anything. Society does not owe you anything. You're not entitled to anything simply because you exist. Men are stronger than women. For a woman to win against a man in a strength contest, you would have to put a pro heavyweight woman wrestler against a skinny nerd. My universal fact is that in order for us to truly value certain morals, the opposite of what we value also asterisk has to exist. Asterisk otherwise we lose focus on why those morals are valued, because then they become a part of societal expectations and are not important to us as individuals. I.e. In order for Batman to measure himself and his coat as a set of values, he needs the Joker to test them. Whenever somebody says to you we should probably see other people, that means that there's already other people. There are only two genders. ADHD is real. If undiagnosed in childhood, could have disastrous life consequences for adults. It's not just about being hyper and bouncing up and down off the walls or not being able to focus. It can lead to a lifetime of bad choices, impulsive actions, poor financial skills, relationship problems, problems making and keeping friends, substance abuse, mood swings and emotional problems, and anxiety, depression, OCD are often comorbid conditions, etc. Not everyone is ADHD if you can't focus or concentrate on something every now and then, and it isn't just about medicating hyperkids. It's a really shitty disorder to have. No one has any idea what is going on. Everyone is just winging it. Every day we make all these plans and it mostly works out, so people think they have control over their life. They do not. Cereal goes in before the milk. To do it otherwise is that of degenerates and troublemakers. People don't actually want reasonable discussion online, as they have already made up their mind about a certain position, are not open to new information, and will never consider the person they are arguing with's points, because they are only interested in proving them wrong instead of actually exchanging ideas. There are heaps of pretentious people on Reddit. Take this thread for example. I rest my case. Nobody owes you a debate, especially on the internet. I can't stand these Ben Shapiro types going around with debate me practically tattooed on their foreheads. Someone is perfectly within their rights to tell you to duck off without a moderator and judges observing. Screeching about how you're not being met in logical and rational debate over whatever opinion you might have honestly just signals that you want to browbeat someone with your views. There is no such thing as the perfect person for you. The way you find that person is you work to be that person. No one is like that by default. Religion is a useful tool to teach people ethics and societal expectations when they can think deeply enough to comprehend the ramifications of their actions. Johnny doesn't get that it's not morally right to do X. But he thinks that if he does X, an all-knowing sky man will lightning bolt him. So it works.